Each video, we take a choice of painting and we discuss on our thoughts and opinions. We don't need to give the character a lot of magical achievements and never rubbish garbage. So if you have the same as you and don't want to hear said spoilers, you can have them along. Also, it's the real event and you can talk in the next video. Today's movie is Thor.
Yeah.
work and the juggernauts showing of the battle scenes and stuff like that, which I felt were very Barbarians-esque, because I very reminiscent of Sauron fighting in the first movie. And the bit of
the other thing they were doing.
Yeah.
Right.
So it was seemed like it was so like this it just works. So it's nice.
Prior to that,
pretty sure God powerful too, but they're not like these gods with this magic hammer. They're kind of getting the crap beat out of them, like you just kind of have your fun. So, yeah, it's kind of not very kind of the word. So, it's kind of his buddies, his friends. Yes.
It's 3 years. I'll follow them, I guess.
Yeah.
Mars 3 and like he said.
I don't know why they don't include her in Mars 3.
Yes. She clearly is
just as adept at fashion as the other star.
And she's basically part of that group. But I also don't get it because, like, they have to say something like she part of the women in the Warrior.
Yeah.
Ragnarok. There's the Valkyrie.
Maybe this is she's much, much, much older than we know. And she's like before the Mars. That's rude to say. She's just off the culture.
She's like 1500 years ago.
I guess how babies work, or these beings. So we have, what do they call them? Xena? It seems as if they just seem very standard, standard core warriors.
I think they all kind of work.
It's gonna be interesting to get more in their story. Thor's trying to get them going. You mentioned some of their like things that they've done in the past.
Yeah.
But it's like, okay, let's see more of what they could have done, I guess.
And the Dark World tried to flesh out the Asian born little men power pony. Have three different names, but now I'm trying to remember which one was
Swish.
And Cody was not another name. I tried that name for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And that one.
Okay. Yeah. So it's been so long since I've seen that one. I think I've only seen one in years. So, that was going to be coming up on the rewatch list. Then the Warriors 3 quickly fall into a retreat, and the Lord just kind of ignores it, and then at the last one kind of saves them by killing this thing.
It's weird.
I don't know what it is, but they have a dinosaur, I think.
I also learned that they have the trouble because they're so surrounded and
not rising to go well. It's not rising. But of course comes and rescues them, and they're questioning, okay, how do they know about this?
Right.
Which Loki messes down the line that he told Handel, the great Idris Elba, to go and tell Odin right after they get there, to go and try and save them and stop them from starting all this trouble. But it might have been like just another yard, possibly. He didn't call on the light bang, so.
Yeah,
it was the good saint guard. We get kind of a talk now to the purpose that I come in for not only for doing exactly the opposite of what King should do. And kind of like, So, you know, again, this is pretty awesome management, and, you know, here is taken from the court, which was, I thought that was pretty cool, that it's just like force pull and go and just like harass, you know, here from the court, and, destroy some of all his powers and everything, and just sends him on down to Earth. And then the back of the baby, after he loses us again, that
Earth is an interesting choice. That he managed to marry,
It's true.
And he only ended on their new grounds. Yeah, it doesn't really go into why he chose Earth.
Yeah.
Or Midgard.
Midgard, yeah. And I just think he chose any of the other ones we not have. Because these astrophysicists don't end up seeing some kind of fancy Aurora, Einstein prison bridge thing. That's really my thing. So, when we first see Thor coming down there, he still is kind of unsure what's really happening. He's kind of confused and like, okay, what just happened? Did this really just happen? And then he gets very angry and doesn't want anyone to manhandle him. I know it's really hard. Kind of grows out of that as we continue through. Back to these astrophysicists, you have Madame Morgan and Wayne Jane Foster, and he's kind of the love interest and also kind of the second protagonist of the movie. You've got Skarsgård, who I kind of mentioned here in Solidarity, and you've got Darcy, which I didn't write down here. That's right, okay. We have, I remember when I first watched the movie, I thought that Eric Selvig and Jane Foster were having their names the last time, so I just thought they were a father and daughter. So that's his duo.
The other, I thought much of what their relationship was in the first watch through.
Mm-hmm. And I think we hear from Selvig, he's a big talk with Thor, that you know, he knew Jane's father and they worked together.
Yeah.
So I guess they're kind of close, but then also who's his father? Is that necessarily like a foreshadowing to another character or not? But I guess I don't know if there's another some kind of scientist in class and philosophy
there. I think I was kind of assumed that he was dead or something.
Yeah.
It's probably what they were talking about.
Right. Yeah. And how protective something is towards Jane.
You know,
trying to get rid of this crazy person, homeless guy,
you know,
who's wearing cats, apparently, in Darcy's words. Who Darcy's kind of letting realizes that Thor was in that Aurora.
Yeah.
That's kind of a prison bridge thing, because she points it out in the picture. They were printing out this picture of them on the wall, and just like, all right, got these on the wall, don't look at them. That's really the picture about the thing where we need to look at them. Okay, that's wonderful.
Alright, what did you think of Tarzan's character? I know a lot of people don't really like her as much.
He's the other one that just kind of some comic relief.
Yeah.
And that, the only scene that really kind of sticks in my mind is when Shield shows up and Coulson shows up and takes all their equipment, takes all their notes and everything, and Darcy just kind of like, just down the three songs on that. This is kind of a serious moment. I just lost years of research, but yeah, okay.
I know
story. But I think that's the goal of those types of characters.
Yeah.
So whatever.
That's really very interesting. Just this town.
Yeah, it's more like 2,000 population or something like that. So he kind of confronts him in that program. this interaction between Thor and the astrophysicist trio, where they still kind of hate just this crazy guy.
Yeah.
But Jane says, well, I'm just going to go and take you to the satellite. Because for whatever reason you're interested in, you said you will give me the answers to these questions. Trying to figure out who you really are, more than just shows that even with Thor being banished, his people, his father, and Quentin are still trying to be aware of what's going on with them. They still care about them. They want to know what he's up to. So it's not just that they banish him and forget about him, but they were still keeping an eye on him. Which I think is a really interesting character for Heimdall, with this kind of like magic eye, all-seeing eye, all-seeing kind of character. It's like, even the Warriors 3, when they talk about needing to go to Midgard, to Earth, and try and find Thor, like, we can't talk about this Heimdall, like, you listen. And then, literally, the Gargoyles says, Heimdall wants to talk to you. So I was like, oh man, I just love that character. It's so fun. Thor was eventually able to leave this facility, this complex, when Sully goes in to Sully Pierce and, and of course, she like immediately is able to fact check and see if it's a fake. As they're running us up into Rocky Island Power, Colson says something like, keep them away from the bars, and then they will leave the rest of you. And they're walking them at the bar as drinking. And so, again, there's these little bits of comedy and these movies where it's like, they get another round, and Sully says, all right, you need to leave, you just gotta leave now. And so, oh my goodness, how many people you imagine can say that they had some drinking battle with the Lord of God of Thunder? So that's a pretty cool badge for yourself to wear. How do you know? But shortly after that, we get the Warrior 3 here down to Midgard, and then meet up with Thor, and
the destroyer.
Thor goes after Loki, frees his Heimdall, and brings the Frost Giants into Asgard, and it sends the destroyer to go and stop Thor. Loki clearly had this bigger plan that your meals at the end of the movie that he's trying to cut off the Frost Giants. He's trying to look like a hero.
Yeah.
So why do you send the destroyer down to go kill Thor? Was one of the questions that was in my mind. Like, did he really need to do that?
He was trying to basically go out and distort as evil, basically.
So yeah, it's probably just kind of like being up on board and saying, I have certain powers as well.
Yeah.
It's possible. Yeah, it's possible. And definitely, like, the fight with the destroyer. The destroyer bot.
Yeah.
When it first shows up, and I was just like, or not also put the other directing guys, like, the guy in stars? I don't know. It's great, it's so good. So it definitely shows that, like, that Tony Stark is still kind of secretive.
Yeah.
I'm not sure at this point if he even works for you, because he was kind of just doing a consult.
And I don't know if they're putting in Avengers together, actually, at another point.
Right.
Because in the block, I think that Avengers, the United States Avengers program was struck.
No.
So I don't think it really got anywhere.
That's true. Yeah. So, but Thor has this flex with this destroyer bot, and basically speaks to Loki through it, saying, stand down. Take what I left and let Earth be.
Yeah.
Right? And so he says, perfect.
Well, I guess the destroyer, the scene where the destroyer's shooting the other, it's like, that goes without me. The destroyer seemed to remind me a lot of Infinity War, but
really hasn't done it. Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Here, I guess the beam is coming out of the destroyer's head, so I just kind of aim from the head there.
Wherever that car is destroyed, the aircraft,
yes,
the damage comes out of
Yeah, and in our recovery session, the first one is because we kind of talk about it. I was like, oh, yeah, yeah, I see that. Okay, but then I don't remember consciously thinking, oh, yeah, that's a nut shop. So that's why I guess I'll have to go back and see when were those occurring? Was there like a good maybe some
meeting? Yeah, right before. Right before we start shooting, we're watching that, you know, seeing where the orbits of the ants are going. And since we were really kind of up on the head, I was noticing it more in how the company shots.
Or were interesting.
Right, yeah, there's an interesting one that we're also looking down at for looking at our images for this silver sword in the arm and welded and we're trying to catch up the same level of the current camera as opposed to looking at the
other
that
makes sense.
The balance and
that's interesting. That is interesting. It's like I'm working on getting a little bit different perspective from the character because the character is no longer looking where you're actually looking.
Yeah.
I remember what it seems on screen. But that's kind of I wonder how that would work if you make how you tell to when you like disorient the newer thing on where are they looking now? If it like creates like a stronger connection for the viewer to understand the line of sight that the character has in mind. I don't know. I'm just going to talk about my plan now at all. I didn't really get a chance to listen to you as much was the soundtrack.
Yeah.
I noticed. And I feel like this is something that I just noticed a lot for that like this like the motifs and the themes that were for Asgard being the same kind of motifs and themes that were used like when Thor is reborn past Thor and just like we get more again. It kind of plays that same little theme. So I don't know if it's necessary. The first theme was just like this.
The main theme was called Hedwig's theme. So like the Star Wars, like Luke's theme is the same theme as like the Force theme.
That's true. So like certain motifs and themes, like a title might be associated with one or another thing, but then also used in other contexts.
Yeah.
And you can listen to the comment section below to join the discussion and add any other questions that you might have and subscribe.
So you know, our next video where we are going to be discussing the next MCU movie of Captain America, the First Avenger.
This has been FoxTales Movie Club. Thanks for watching. I'm Terry.
I'm Fox, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.